once again, I am Joraul Farley for this InfoCast tutorial about today how to set up an iPod and an iTunes account. First of all, what you are going to want to do is go into Firefox. Right now, I have it on Google Translate, so I'm just going to go to www.apple.ca. Then, you're going to go into iTunes. And then, you'll see this little button here that says Download Now. Click it. Then, all you have to do is press Download Now. You do not have to enter your email address, however. You can download this for Mac or PC. On this case, since I am on a Mac, I'll just press Download Now. But if you are on a Windows, you can simply click down here and then press Download Now. As I am on a Mac, I will press Get It for Macintosh, but everything that I say here will be applied on a PC as well. You press Download Now, and it will open with this here. Now that it is complete downloading, it will ask you to simply open the application, which will look like a round CD. Click it, and iTunes will open. As you see, iTunes will open. You'll probably show up with the things that you have on at this point in time. In this case, I'm on my podcasts. Now, it seems fairly simple to set up your iPod. First of all, charge it. In my case, my iPod will take a few minutes to charge first. Once it is done charging, you will see where it says iTunes Store. Right above that, there will be the little icon that says iPod, and you're going to want to set up your new iPod the way that I instruct you. Then, your iPod, every time you connect it, will go through this process. If you want to add new things, simply under the Devices pane, as I said, just below the iTunes Store, you will see the name of your iPod or iPhone. This will happen on a PC or a Mac. Click it. Okay, here we are. Now, it's rather easy. From here on, all you have to do is select what you want. You can check for updates, and if you're experiencing problems or you want to go back to a previous version, you can bring it back to its original settings by clicking Restore. Now you can change your apps, music, movies, TV shows, podcasts, books, photos, and information. This is how your home screen will look. You can move things around if you want, though in my case, I wouldn't want to just yet. Once you're done adding all the stuff that you want to, or the stuff that you feel you need, it's time to set up an iTunes account. It's fairly easy to set up an iTunes account. If it hasn't already asked you when setting up your iPod, now you can. Under the account tab that you will find down by the bottom of the page, press create account. It will say accessing iTunes. Simply press continue. Press I have read and agreed to these terms and conditions. And press continue. Then enter all of your credentials and press continue. That's as far as I'll take it. And have fun using iTunes and your new iPod or iPhone. Thank you. And for InfoCast tutorials, I am Joraul Farley. Don't forget to watch InfoCast News later, and please do subscribe.